Today we look at Kirchhoff's laws of electrical networks. Thanks for tuning in, it's Kisembo Academy. Kirchhoff's laws of electrical networks are basically two. We'll explore one by one. The first law of electrical networks states that the sum of all currents that are entering any junction is equal to the sum of the currents that are leaving the junction. By junction, we mean a place where wires are connecting, wires are meeting. For example, in this simple illustration here, at this junction, you're having currents I1 and I2 moving in, and at that same junction you're having currents I5, I4, I3. So the law simply states that the sum of these currents that are getting in, which is I1 plus I2, should be equal to the sum of the currents that are moving out of that junction, which is I3 plus I4 plus I5. That is just one of the versions of that law. Still looking at that same junction, we can still describe this law as that the algebraic sum of all the currents at that junction is equal to zero. And when we mean the algebraic sum, we mean that the currents that are getting into the junction are positives, positive I1 and positive I2, and the currents that are leaving the junctions are negative currents. So the algebraic sum of all these currents is equal to zero. That is the first law of Kirchhoff. So the second law of Kirchhoff's, in any closed loop, the algebraic sum of all the EMFs in that loop should be equal to the algebraic sum of all the potential drops. Alternatively, we all know that the principle of conservation of energy states that energy is neither created nor destroyed but can be converted from one form to another. So, in this alternative way of looking at it, the principles of energy are implied, and so the principle of energy that the directed sum of the electrical potential differences or the voltage in any closed loop circuit is always equal to zero. You can look at it like that. So it means that if you get the summation of the total potential differences or the total voltages in a closed circuit, their algebraic sum should be equal to zero. Now, what exactly is a loop? A loop can either be clockwise or anticlockwise, as long as it is in a closed circuit, like we shall illustrate later. So you need to know that if you have chosen to make your loops clockwise in a certain circuit, then they all have to be clockwise. If you've chosen that they should be anticlockwise, then they should all be anticlockwise for a given particular circuit. The next, the sign allocated to the potential difference and the EMF will depend on the direction of flow of current in the resistor in relation to the direction in which the loop is traversed, like we shall illustrate. Let's look at the sign convention that we shall be using in our calculations in Kirchhoff's laws of electrical networks. These two are resistors and these two are sources of EMF. In our calculations, we shall be considering the loop. We shall either draw a clockwise loop or an anticlockwise loop. And it is the direction of that loop that is going to determine how we shall be assigning these signs, the negative or the positives, on the potential drops that are within that loop. Now, if the loop is moving in a direction such that the direction is the same as the direction of flow of current through a certain resistor, it means that looking at this loop, it means that current is moving in from in here and getting out here. It is assumed that current is going to move from a position of higher potential towards the position of lower potential. So it means that as current is going through this potential, this resistor, as by our loop, there will be a potential drop. And because of that potential drop, it means that our PD across this will be a negative. Coming to this loop is moving in the opposite direction to the flow of current. Now, because this loop is moving in the opposite direction to the flow of current, with respect to this loop, we see that it is moving from a position of lower potential to a position of higher potential in as regards to the flow of current through this resistor. So as far as this direction of loop is concerned, there is a voltage gain as we move from this direction to that direction. And so whenever there is those two moving in the opposite direction, we shall have a potential gain. A voltage gain, and so that will be a positive IR. Then coming to our sources of EMF, we know that the general convention is that current will always move from the positive terminal, will go through the circuit, and will enter the circuit, the cell into the via the negative terminal. So if the loop is such that it is coinciding with the correct direction of flow of current within the cell, which correct direction is that current, as it's moving through the cell, it will be moving from the negative to the positive, then that EMF is positive. But if the loop is traversing in a direction such that it is opposing the normal flow of current within the cell, then it means that the EMF in that cell will be regarded to as negative. In our previous assertion, we said that the sum of the potential drops, or the sum of the PDs within a closed loop is equal to zero. So this here is a closed loop. It means that when current gets out of this cell here, it's going to move across and it will come back there. So it means from the positive terminal back to the negative terminal. So it means that this is a closed loop, and so all the potential, the voltages within this loop must be equal to zero. So we shall start with the potential voltage across A, which is a cell. So the voltage across A will be a positive. Why is it a positive? Because we are moving from, the loop is in the same direction as the flow of current within the cell, which is from negative going through the cell to the positive side, then it comes out via the positive side. Then we come to this resistor. This direction of current is moving in that direction, so it means that this side of the resistor will be positive, or it will have a higher potential, and this side will have a lower potential. But, and since our loop is traversing in that direction, in the same direction, it means that as we are moving in, as our loop is incoming here, it is going to experience a voltage drop across this resistor. And so it means we shall have a negative voltage across here. When we come, as our loop traverses in this direction, the loop, the direction of the loop is coinciding with the direction of the flow of current through this cell, as the current flowing through the cell is assumed to move from negative to positive, so that makes it a positive voltage, voltage VB. Then as we are moving, the current is moving, it is entering from here, so this, the point of entry is the point of higher potential, the point of exit of the current is the point of lower potential, but then the loop is moving in that direction, so it means that as current is moving through here, it is experiencing a voltage drop. So as it's experiencing a voltage drop, that makes this voltage across this a negative VD, and that is the same case with VE, and that is equal to zero. So we have the total sum of all the potentials in this loop being equal to zero. And if we are to make the EMFs to be on one side and the resistances, all the potential drops to be on the other side, then you will have VA plus VB, which are the EMFs in this loop, being equal to the sum of the potential drops. So that is definitely, that is basically Kirchhoff's laws, that the sum of the EMFs in the circuits, as we have seen, is equivalent to the sum of the potential drops in that same circuit. In our upcoming videos, we shall be looking at examples that will illustrate, that will require us to use Kirchhoff's laws. This brings us to the end of this video. Thank you for watching. Somebody out there needs to watch this video. Don't forget to like and share. For more videos, simply subscribe to Kisembo Academy. Otherwise, catch you in the next video. For Kisembo Academy, this is Arnold Rangakuranya.